girl, let me spill the tea for you. I love looking like a fifth grader when I'm actually a sophomore. I don't care. Like, I really just don't care. I'm here trying to, like, pass my history class. How to get a boyfriend if you've never spoken to a boy. Welcome back to my channel. I know that I was gone for a few weeks, but I have missed talking to you guys, sitting in my room, but I'm finally back. I'm back on schedule, new videos every single Saturday, so stay tuned. But this week's video is gonna be a freshman slash high school advice video. I know that I don't really have a lot of high school experience, but you know, I made it through freshman year, so this is to you incoming freshmen, or if you're a freshman already, this video is for you. One of the questions that I got asked the most was how to stay motivated to keep your grades up. And I'm just gonna be completely brutally honest, you're just gonna have to push yourself through and just tell yourself that you can do it. Because at the end of the day, or at the end of the 4 years, your GPA is really what determines your life, because your GPA determines what college you're gonna go to, and that determines what job you're gonna get, and you know the rest. It's the truth, it's sad, but it is what it is, and you can't do anything to change it, so do not slack off, especially if you're a freshman. I know that many people might say that freshman year doesn't count, or like it's not really that important, but at the end of those 4 years, your GPA gets averaged out. So if you had C's and D's or F's all of freshman year, that's really gonna bring down your GPA, which is not really something you want, because I don't really know this yet, but everyone says that freshman year is the easiest year, and it probably is since it's the first year. So just tell yourself that you can do it. When you come home with those straight A's, you're just gonna be like, damn, I deserve that. I did everything that I was supposed to do, and I deserved all those A's, and then you're gonna be so proud of yourself, and that's basically all I can say. Another question that I got asked a lot was how to deal with fake friends. And girl, if your friends are fake, you need to distance yourself from them immediately and find new friends. If you don't wanna be harsh and break their heart, you can obviously go the easier way, take the high road and kind of just distance yourself from them. You know, if you're making plans, don't invite them, or if they invite you to their plans, don't really go. And if they come up to you and ask you about why there's like this distance, tell the truth. If something's going on, I will tell you about it. I will confront you. I will not, you know, be that little girl in the back and just be like, oh yeah, like it's fine, like who cares? Like, no. If you have something to say about me, say it to my face, or I will come up to your face and ask you about it. Because I'm that annoying little girl that will stand up for herself. Just be like, please. See, once you got rid of those fake friends, you need to find some new friends, and that's the new topic we're talking about. How to find new friends, and how to find friends that are right for you. And if you know me and a little bit of background of me, you know that I have been to many different schools and I've moved a lot. So finding new friends is really not that hard for me anymore because I've kind of mastered it. I've had to make new friends almost every single year or every 2 years. And honestly, the best advice that I can give you about finding new friends is just going for it. I know it can be really hard if you're shy or if you have social anxiety, but honestly, you just have to go for it. You just have to be really outgoing, and you just need to just go up to that person and be like, hey, what's up? What's your name? That's literally what I've been doing since I was 5 years old. I'm not kidding. I don't know anybody when I moved to Dubai. I don't know anybody when I moved to LA, but guess what? Like, I made these friends. I just went up to them, I talked to them, and I was like, that's a cute shirt. Wanna be friends? Wow, this cop. Also, don't try to focus on making friends just in your school. Try to branch out and make friends from other schools. I have more friends from other schools than I have friends in the school that I go to right now. I don't really care. I don't really mind that. You know, I think it's better because if you see one person constantly over and over again, like every single day for 180 days, you kind of get sick of them. But see, if you have friends that go to other schools, you don't get sick of them. One question I got asked was, should I challenge myself with a lot of hard classes or take it easy? I'm kind of struggling with the same thing right now. I'm probably gonna go for the challenging classes just because I know that it's gonna be worth it at the end of my years. I obviously don't want to leave anything hard for junior year because I'm already going to be starting to take APs because that's when you take your AP classes and you take your SATs, so it's already going to be really stressful. So I don't really want to add on to that stress, so I prefer to take all my challenging classes that I can take right now. I'm doing 3 honors right now and it's going pretty easy. I mean, I'm not really struggling with it that much just yet. I mean, it's only the 3rd day of school, so we don't really know. But honestly, I would just say do it. Like I said earlier, you're just gonna have to push yourself through it because when it's senior year and you've like completed all your credits and you're just gonna be like leaving school at 12, like my sister did, I'm just gonna be like cruising down the street, like being like, ha, losers, you gotta complete your credits. I already did mine. How to stay out of drama? Girl, let me spill the tea for you. Just don't be involved in it. Just don't be involved in it. There is drama, but I don't pay attention to it. I don't associate myself with it. I do not get involved with it. I've always been someone that's just looked from afar and just been like, that's dumb. Like, why are they doing that? Like, that's so stupid. Like, you guys are really immature. And then I just walk away. I don't need someone else's drama that I don't care about, like, in my life. Like, I already got problems of my own. I don't need to deal with yours, okay? I don't care. Like, I really just don't care. I'm here trying to like pass my history class and you're gonna tell me about some stupid girl and like what she said. Like, I don't care. I just don't care. I'm there to do my work and get the hell out. How do you know who is toxic and who is actually good for you? That is actually a really good question, and it might take you months, years to find out who's actually a good person. But I feel like the most toxic relationships are the ones that are one-sided. Sometimes people will put more effort into a friendship than the other person. You expect that person to, you know, give you the same kind of attention and the same kind of effort, but at the end of the day, they just don't really care and they just focus on themselves and they always talk about their problems and this and that. Everything's basically about them and you're always there for them, but they're never really there for you. If your friend is not supporting you, if your friend is not supportive of your decisions and does not care about your happiness, that is not a good friend. That is not a friend that you need in your life. It's a friend that you need to cut out immediately. How to get a boyfriend if you've never spoken to a boy? Me. I don't know. Someone asked how to stop caring about what other people think. Ooh, girl, I'm here to save your day. This is my area. This is where I swoop in and be the hero. You just have to learn how to ignore all of those negative people that like to make comments about you. Again, this is one of those things that take time. And I know there's a common phrase that everyone says, fake it till you make it. And you can obviously fake your way through being confident and not caring about what other people say. But obviously, it's gonna take a little bit more than that. You just gotta learn how to ignore them. And you also need to learn that people that talk shit behind your back or that say bad things about you don't really have anything better to do with their lives than to make stupid remarks and comments about other people. If someone is so focused on someone else, do you really think that they're a smart, intelligent individual? If you just don't react to it, they're just gonna stop because they're gonna get bored. They're not gonna get the entertainment out of it. And if they think that it's entertaining, they're also kind of psycho. But if you just don't react and if you just ignore them, you know what? They're just gonna stop bothering you. And this is the truth. Literally, this is how it works. This is how bullies and how immature people work. Don't react to them and they'll just leave you alone. What to do when you're overwhelmed? I'm guessing that this is relating to some schoolwork that you're going through. When you're feeling overwhelmed, that's when you know that you gotta kind of take it back, rewind, just remind yourself that it's all gonna be okay. And just, if it helps you, make a little to-do list so you're a little bit more organized and so a bunch of thoughts aren't going through your brain about what you need to do. Here's my little tip about homework. If you have a lot that's, some of it's hard and some of it's like not really that hard, it's easy, it's gonna go by fast, start off with the hard one because once the hard one's over, you're gonna be like, oh my god, these are so easy, and you're just gonna go through them really fast. Also, if you do like a bunch of easy ones and then a big hard one at the end, your brain's already gonna be tired. Even though they're easy, you're still doing work, so your brain's like working anyway. But if you do like the biggest, like really hard one, and you take like a 10-minute break, then you're gonna realize how easy the worksheets are. So that's my little tip on homework. I got you, girl. I hope it helped you. I mean, it helps me. That's the way I do my homework. Start off with the hardest and go to the easiest, because then it's just gonna feel like a breeze. Are there a lot of hot boys just like in the movies? I'm so curious. No. 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 High school is not like the movies at all. And I wasn't really expecting it to be like the movies, because like I know it's a Hollywood movie. I mean, there's three mean girls, one really hot guy, one like lonely girl that's not really confident, and then she goes through this like huge confident boost, and then like she's all pretty, and then like all the guys are obsessed with her, and then the mean girls try to ruin her life, blah blah blah. Yeah, no, it's not really like that. Everyone just kind of minds their own business. There's some girls that like to be petty and talk bad about you. Yeah, at least that's what it's like in my school. Yeah, there aren't hot boys. Mm-mm. We don't got no Troy Bolton at our school, I'm sorry. What happens when high school girls constantly start rumors about you, and why? Okay, so if you're dealing with those mean bully girls that can be really intimidating and scary, you just have to go up to them and confront them, and yeah, basically that's what I would do. If anyone is starting a rumor about me or saying something about me that's not true, I'm the type of person to just go up to them and be like, yo man, what's the problem? Like, if you have something to say about me, if you're gonna start shit about me, come say it to my face. You know, don't go telling Emily and then go telling Betty and then go tell Amy. Like, what are you, five? If people are asking you if the rumor is true or not, just say the truth and just be like, no man, it's not true. You know it's not true, your friends know it's not true, so it doesn't really matter. Who cares about those random people that you don't even talk to and you just smile at in the hallway? Who cares? Someone asked something about dress code, and that is also my area. Girl, I went to the office probably every single day. There were days where I would get sent to the office before homeroom. I don't even know how that's possible, but yeah, it got to a point where I literally would get sent out of the classroom, and I was supposed to go to the office. I would take a lap around school, come back up and be like, oh yeah, they were fine with it. And they're just like, oh, okay. Yeah, literally, it got to a point like that. In my middle school, I was not allowed to wear ripped jeans. I would carry a sock, a black sock, and whenever the principal or the vice principal passed by, I would put the sock on the rip, so it would just look like there's no rip at all, and I would just cheat my way through school. When I first started high school, like there was apparently like this new dress code that was gonna be abused. I remember my biology teacher saying that if we didn't follow these rules, we would get suspended. And I remember shouting in the class saying, if my education is gonna be interrupted because the way I dress is disruptive to boys, we have not made any progress over the years. It's 2018, I'm sorry. But you need to control the boys, okay? I'm not gonna change the way I dress. I'm not gonna change my attitude. Like, I'm not gonna change anything about me so that this boy can learn peacefully, okay? If he's turned on by my shoulders, that's his problem, okay? He's got something in his head then, okay? It's not my shoulders, it's him. Okay, I think that's the last question I'm gonna answer, because I have been filming for over an hour and a half and this is gonna be a really long video to edit. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hoped it helped any of you freshmen or anyone in high school or anyone that needs advice. I hope it helped you. And I love you guys so much, and I will see you next week. Bye guys.